Hello students, I'm Chef Preeti Sinhal and today I'm going to demonstrate you one of the cooking method which is a steaming. Steaming is one of the most commonly used method of cooking. It comes under moist cooking method or moist cooking technique. Or if I would say in layman's terms, it is a principle of cooking where the food is placed over boiling water. And it's covered with a lid to trap the steam, and then that steam cooks the food. So actually the steam circulating around the food provides the even and moist environment that allows the food to retain moisture and its flavor and natural juices. This cooking technique is actually a very, very ancient way of cooking. If I would say that this technique is intimately related with boiling. Food is cooked over water at a rolling boil, whereas at boiling point, when the water molecules one changing to steam or gas, and so the temperature is slightly higher than the boiling point of water. This is how the steaming works. We can add herbs, we can add stock, we can add wine to enhance the flavor of the food. Now there are different types of steaming method, in that direct steaming, indirect steaming and steaming with pressure. So I'm going to show you over here the different these different methods. Under that, the direct steam method, where food comes in the direct contact with the steam, like your idlis we cook, the way we cook momos, modak. Whereas if I talk about indirect steam, the food does not directly come under the contact with the steam. So I'm going to show you over here. In indirect steam, if I would say the example are your dhokla, then puddings. These are the ones which cooked under that method. Next is steam with pressure. In that, it generates the pressure using steam, so the temperature increases inside and the food cook faster. Like you have seen the pressure cooker, which has it is an enclosed container which has a whistle on it, which controls the steam. And because of that enclosed one, it increases the temperature and the food cooks faster. So these are different methods. In that, today I'm going to show you direct method and indirect method. So let's look at the technique of cooking that way. So now let's look at the ingredients and the equipments we are going to use it for the indirect method of steaming. So let me explain you. For that, I have taken a thick bottom of and a bigger size of container. In that, I have put a ring. This is the container which I am going to use for the food, for the cooking. Today I am cooking the dhokla. The batter is over here which I have prepared. That dhokla batter will go inside, and this is a lid for the my container, and one lid for the container of the food. So how it works, let me tell you. So over here there is a ring which will lift it little bit above. In that I am going to put my container, which will be filled with the batter of the dhokla. That container will be again covered with a lid, and on top of that I am going to put another lid, so the steam is inside. So over here what is happening, when the water will start boiling, after boiling the molecule will turn into gas or steam. That steam should not touch directly in the indirect method. So the container in which I am putting food, that is also covered. So over here, if you understand this, that the direct steam is not coming in the contact with food. This is what the principle of indirect cooking method. But now to entrap that steam so the food cooks properly, this container will be again covered with a tight lid so the food cooks properly. So let's look at the overall process. I'm going to start with cooking of dhokla. Now, as you can see, the water I have poured in that is rolling boiling. I have prepared the batter for the dhokla. That I am going to keep it in the container. Immediately, I am going to cover it with the lid. Now the steam will create. Steam is going to generate in that, and I am covering it with the another lid. Now the very important thing, the container which you are keeping that, and the container which you are going to cover the main container in which the water is creating the steam. That between that lid and that container there should be some space, so the steam can move around it, and the food can cook properly and evenly. So I'm going to cover it. Now for the next 20 minutes, I'm going to cook the dhokla. So let's cook the dhokla for further 20 minutes. Now till that indirect method of steaming, in that the food is getting cooked, let's look at the another method of steaming cooking. In that, this is a direct method which I'm going to show you. The ingredient which I have taken over here is the idli batter. So now let's talk about how this technique works. So this is a container which has a lid on it. I hope you are able to see in that. In that, what I have done, I have added water at the base level. I am going to boil that water. On top of that, I have put a perforated or the holes one. A plate. This is the mold which I am taking to cook my food. This is a idli steamer, everybody knows, I am sure. So now I am going to fill these with the idli batter, and we are going to put it on that. Now the water is boiling from the bottom. Steam is after that, steam will generate, and that steam will come in the contact of the food by these holes. That steam will rise, it will cover, it will come everywhere. We are going to close that, and now inside that container, everywhere steam is there, and which is going to cook the food. The steam is going to circulate around the food. So in this method, I think you understood that food is directly coming in the contact with the steam and getting cooked. This is known as direct method of steam. So let's cook the idli in that direct method of cooking. As we have kept the water for boiling, now water has started boiling. So I am going to add the container in which I have added the prepared batter of idli. Now slowly the steam will generate. And with the help of these holes, this will come on all over the food. It will surround it, and I'm going to cover it with a lid. This is how the direct method works, where now the steam will cook the food in that. So let's wait till the idli cooks. So another, I think, 10 to 12 minutes will take for cooking the idli. Now it's almost 10 minutes, and my idli is almost cooked. As you can see, the steam has generated. You can see over here the condensation little bit, which you can see over here, and then that steam goes around the food and cooks it. Let me show you by taking it out. This is how the idli is cooked. Now let's see the plating of all the idlis have cooked properly. I'm going to take them out from the mold, and let's see the plating. As we have finished our steaming cooking method or cooking technique, so over here with the direct method we have cooked idli. With the indirect method we have cooked dhokla over here. So once again I'll explain. The direct method, in that the water is boiling in the container. We fill the food, whatever we want to cook, and then we put it inside. There are holes in that container. From that the steam comes up and the steam, the food comes into contact with the steam. That is how the food gets cooked, and then we cover it. This is how the direct method works. Now for the indirect method, the container in which we are putting the food item, whatever we want to cook, we have decided to cook, that container also gets covered, and then that container is kept in a bigger container where the water is boiling and after that steam is generating. That we keep it inside and we cover it, so the container in which the food is there is get covered with the steam, but the food does not come in the contact with the direct steam. So this is how the indirect method works. So over here the idli is prepared and over here the dhokla is prepared. The nice beautiful bright color has come, and this is very spongy and light. And as you can see, look over here, a nice spongy beautiful idli has come. Same way the dhokla has also come up. The net has created a very nicely, and this is how the steam cooks the food proper. This cooking method is one of the healthiest cooking method, in that the moisture of the food stays with it, the flavor that stays there itself, and there is a very less oil which is used in this cooking method. So I think that justifies itself. This is a very healthy way of cooking. So I'm sure, students, that with this demonstration you have understood the direct method of steaming technique, indirect method of steaming technique. And as we all know, there is, I have explained to you, there is a steam with pressure, another way which we do in our pressure cooker with the whistle on it. In that we cook our potatoes or dal, we do steamed rice. This is how that method is used. Guys, try to make that as much time as possible, so you will acquire that skill slowly to bring out a better output while using this method. And all the best. Have a good day. Thank you.